Hello, my name is Vaikuntan Rajaratnam. In this presentation, I'm going to talk about the journey of a surgeon and how one prepares oneself for this path that one has chosen of becoming a surgeon. Following graduation, when one chooses a path in postgraduate training, generally one has 4 decades of active practice that prior to retiring. And in the first decade, as a surgeon, you prepare yourself to train in the speciality that you have chosen. And this is about 10 years in which you reach a level of mastery. In the second decade of your journey as a surgeon is when you consolidate your practice. Following your training and exiting as a consultant in surgery, you then proceed to hone your skills as psychomotor speciality requires repetition and deliberate practice to achieve a level of mastery. And in the second decade is when you achieve this and are ready to pass on your legacy. In the third decade is when you are ready to pass your legacy, the skills and knowledge that you have gained over 12 decades of training and practice in surgery, when you pass this on to your trainees. You're now in a position to pass the art and science of surgery to your trainees, which is part and parcel of a surgeon's career. In the fourth decade of the surgeon's life, you should start preparation for his fifth decade with the accepted declining in psychomotor skills that would occur. He needs to alter his practice to change to that which suits his competencies with aging. And also at this stage is to look trans-border and international commitments to needs that may be available in other communities where he could use his knowledge, skills and experience to establish systems and processes to improve surgical training and education to affect the healthcare in other communities. What I have learned in my journey as a surgeon has been validated with the grant study, and I truly found that in my various decades of training and practicing and teaching others in surgery is that the relationships between the mentor, my peers and my mentees has been the one that provides the greatest amount of satisfaction and has produced the amount of richness in one's life. And therefore, relationship is the foundation of being a successful surgeon. Relationships with your peers, with your mentors, your mentees, patients, and your family members. Your journey on a surgical path begins after medical school when you decide on surgery as your specialty. It is important to know why is it that you're doing what you want to do. And it is important that you learn from your peers, your mentors, and experience what it is like being a surgeon. Being a surgeon is very, very different from being a physician, and already the demands and the expectations are going to be higher and higher. First, you need to know where are you in the scale of things and the cohort, where do you lie? First, to understand that within the population that you are not mean, mode or median, and that you are at least 1 or 2 standard deviation to the right of the normal distribution curve. To excel in surgery, one needs to push oneself to maybe even up to the level of 6 standard deviation to the right. This sounds almost impossible, but specializing in the impossibility is what surgery is all about. So first you decide what kind of a surgeon do you want to be. Do you be an average surgeon, or you want somebody to be 2 standard deviation to the right, or maybe even 5 standard deviation to the right? You need to then decide on the niche area in which you want to specialize in, and then you start to profile yourself and brand yourself in that specialty even in the early stage, showing an interest with tangible evidence that you are interested in the area, and this can be in the form of doing research or experimenting with new ideas. And this has to be made public both regionally, nationally, and internationally. And once you get into this track, then you start thinking about leaving a legacy that is to train others, that even while in training, you got to start preparing to building your network and collaboration so that you can help your mentees obtain opportunities to excel. And during this period of time, you must secure financial independence so that you are able to use your talent and your experience in doing things for the community without worrying about financial sustenance. And therefore, a good financial planning is important as a surgeon that you may be able to fulfill the needs of an international community. And your alignment is very important, your spiritual alignment, whatever it may be. But please do take note, do not bring religious dogma into your clinical practice, and that is unprofessional. Now, how do you excel as a learner? You have to be an excellent learner to be able to succeed as a surgeon. To be excellent in learning, you need to be effective in learning. How could you learn things quickly, just in time, whatever technique that suits you? You have to be an effective communicator. Without being able to communicate with your peers, with your mentors and your mentees, you will not be a successful surgeon. You need to be an effective collaborator. Effective collaborator in training could be to share your workload and your surgical profile and to enhance learning for yourself and for others, providing the opportunity for those who are unable to obtain the opportunity so as to see that one is able to grow together as a team. And also later in collaboration, in research, in teaching, this becomes very useful. To be effective, one needs to be able to optimize one's learning time. Optimization occurs through the use of effective learning strategies, like the use of e-learning, heutagogy, as is called the technical term, which is self-directed learning. You need to automate most of the processes that which can be automated, in terms of scheduling, in terms of referencing, in terms of collecting knowledge. So using automated technology to help in your learning process. And that which can be outsourced, your processes, you need to outsource. Don't waste too much time on things that can be outsourced. For example, you want to do copy editing of a paper you've written, outsource it to somebody who can do copy editing while you do the more important stuff that requires your attention. So what are the basic qualities of a surgeon? I think at the end of the day, you need to spend some time with a surgeon to understand what it takes to make a good surgeon. A good book is Kevin Dutton's Wisdom of Psychopaths. Don't let the title put you off. Do spend some time reading it. Basically, you require patience as a surgeon. You need fine motor coordination, a mind that is inquiring. You have to be innovative. You have to be oriented to the community. You must be self-critical, but not self-flagellation. And you must strive for mastery. Always striving for mastery. The criteria for a professional, which is what a surgeon is apart from the academic qualification and the specialized skills and knowledge that's required, is a high standard of professional ethics and behavior and work activities that is self-motivated without requirement of supervision and self-guided. And this makes a true professional who focuses their activities towards the betterment of the community rather than for self-gain. And they must be engaged in such activities in their career. So, if you decided on surgery, you must know what part of surgery that you want to do. Be aware, read the literature to know what are the surgical specialities that are dwindling due to the changes in way medicine is practiced, and make sure you choose one that will be able to grow and evolve with time. You must understand why you're doing this. What is it for? What is it that attracts you to surgery? And you gotta love surgery. You must measure the needs and demands of the society for the specialty you've chosen, and whether you have the skill sets that you can attain at the end of your training to be able to achieve that. Remember, there's only one person who's responsible for your training, and that is you. not the Royal Colleges, not your employer, not your mentor. When do you start planning for your surgical career now? As you listen to this talk and you have an interest in surgery, you start your plan now. You plan it in detail, have a discussion with your mentor, map out and chart and navigate your learning path, and you will achieve it. Maslow's hierarchy of needs helps us to understand on our path towards surgical practice. Initially, we take surgery as a means of living to achieve an income in the practice of healthcare. And beyond that, we go towards understanding the importance of surgery in your patient and your practice. As we move higher up, we want to leave a legacy through the teaching and through our mentoring of others. And finally, when we reach self-actualization, we try and change the quality of life through the education and training of other surgeons in other communities. How do you secure a training program? First, you must make sure there is a demand. Look at the needs of the community. Create a specific objective from what you want to get out of your training program. Document your map. How is it you're going to achieve that? And then you're going to execute your plan. But you need to review and replan as you go along, as things may change and circumstances may change. But most important, you have to persevere. So branding and profiling, as mentioned earlier, is an important step in making sure you get into a postgraduate training program in surgery. And for that to occur, the passion must be there that drives you to become very visible through the branding and profiling that you will do even in the undergraduate days as you prepare for your postgraduate surgical training. So how do you do that? Well, communicate with the relevant people. Make sure you are visible, you have a mentor, preferably in the specialty that you have chosen. Discuss with them, discuss who are the opinion leaders, who are the people who make decisions. Make yourself visible, visit the unit, visit the center, show your interest, participate in the activities, in the continuing medical education activities, volunteer, help in registration. All this makes you visible. Question, ask intelligent question. You should, and this should not be done as a means of just showing off, but truly inquiring so that you understand, looking at the subject and your area of interest. You need to acquire the knowledge, you must do the research and the audits, volunteer for that. Even now you could start doing it, and that shows your interest and provides the profiling that you need, and publish. It is possible to even publish good papers at your level. So the type of knowledge that you need to acquire, apart from the academic knowledge, which will be part of the curriculum in your residency program, would be to be familiar with information technology, be able to create database, design and manipulate database, which will be useful for research. You must be able to be proficient in imaging and image management and video recording, as these are all very useful in a surgical career. Preferably try and get certified, get a piece of paper that says that you have the ability to perform this. Number two, you need some basic skills in thinking, reading and writing, and communication. This is important because a lot of the effectiveness of a communicator and a collaborator will require this. Learn to write because it is important part of a surgeon's career in research writing, in paper publication. You need to have good management skills and management of operations, and these are useful because a lot of surgical procedure process based, so things like process re-engineering is a very powerful tool in helping you improve your quality of surgery. You need to know about human resource and people management, finance and marketing, all of which become useful in your career as a surgeon. Research and audits are part and parcel of a surgeon's career. Make sure you start them early, do your audit so you know the quality of the work you do. The move towards patient reported outcome measures are important. Start working on them early. Start incorporating your data for your practice. Learn how to do these, present them in a national and international level, and publish them. Flog it to the maximum and move on to the next project. Surgical training is tough. time is limited, resources are limited. You need to work effectively through collaboration and communication. Start building learning teams. Get your members right, work as a team so that you can divide your work, work together, meet together to support each other, get a mentor involved, and have a clear knowledge acquisition plan. Look at your curriculum, draw out the knowledge, break it down to parts, to weekly topics so that you get the knowledge acquisition. Get your skill acquisition strategy. Learning opportunities are dropping due to time constraints in training, and therefore you need to find ways on how to achieve the skill set due to repetition. You have to have deliberate practice to build skills, and therefore you need to plan these to high fidelity simulation models at home or even to mental practicing. Here's a suggestion for a toolkit that you can use to ensure your training is focused, structured, and concentrated. Have a clear documented specialty training program that is personalized to you. Have a learning log. You must know what you're learning at all times. Use technology to augment and optimize this process. I use Evernote, which is a very useful tool in which you can collect pieces of bits of information that you can then spend time learning about it. Attend courses on creative writing and power reading. Learn about image manipulation. How can I learn how to enhance images that I've taken through the use of a smartphone? Make sure that you do this ethically and with consent. The thing about team building is relationship building. Learn how to build relationships. Relationships are important, not just for the sake of learning, but as creating a spark of living in a community. Keep fit mentally, emotionally, physically, and spiritually. Have the right attitude. These are the important aspects of a kit that you need to know to function effectively as a surgeon. Time management is crucial. As with anything else, keep to important and non-urgent. That is the domain area that you want to be. Stop saying in urgent, non-important issues that are being done is a fruitless effort. Understand the Pareto principle, 80-20 law. Focus your attention on the 20% of the activities that gives you 80% of results. Start maintaining your learning portfolio or a learning log. Some training programs require a mandatory portfolio. Even if it's not mandatory, I strongly recommend. Using Evernote is a useful tool to keep a portfolio. It's so that it's searchable, it's easily, that you can go back and look at it. Use audio to reflect on learning that has occurred. The audio then can be used for your reflection, and keep reflection periodic. At the end of the week, once a week, reflect on what you have learned and be disciplined to keep this going. Financial independence is important for you. If without financial independence, you'll have difficulty doing that which you are passionate about. So think about it. A good book to read is Cashflow Quadrant by Robert Kiyosaki, and you will learn about the four quadrants. You can be in all four quadrants at one time. Choose a plan that works for you. Seek advice so that you can get financial independence quickly, so that you can move on to do that which you are passionate about as far as surgery is concerned. Having the right mental alignment or spiritual alignment is crucial towards the path of being a surgeon. It drives your motivation. It keeps you going even the darkest hours, knowing that at the end of the trail, you're going to make an impact on your patient and your practice and alleviate the suffering of your patients to be. This is the hand surgery residency program in Singapore. It looks an arduous journey, but it is doable. But remember, the end of this is when you exit as a hand consultant, and then you have another decade to consolidate your practice, to hone in on your skill, to reach a stage of mastery, before which then you leave a legacy, and then you leave a legacy that is not only nationally but internationally. So what now? What you have to do is to take some time out, sit down, and decide, is surgery the path that you want? Document your plan, go public, inform your mentor, your tutor, and say, this is what I want to do. So that is important. Then get your action plan going, revisit the plan, and most important, enjoy yourself as you take the journey to be an excellent surgeon that meets the needs of yourself and your patients. Thank you, and goodbye.